During video game development, it's very rare the game's story is implemented in the first few months. And this is also the case with Dead Rising. However, Dead Rising has a very bumpy history when it comes to its release. Dead Rising was originally aiming to release on launch day of the Xbox 360 in 2005. However, the team eventually realized they would not make that deadline, and thus pushing the game's release further back time and time again until August of 2006. However, the simple fact that they were trying to push the game to make launch day means there was obviously quite a lot of the game finished in 2005. Now, in 2005, we were shown many milestones of the game, such as 2005 E3, and then the TGS event a few months after. Both the builds showcased were extremely early, but had a considerable amount of assets that were finished, implemented, and working. Now, if the game was in a state of near release in 2005, or so they initially thought, that means the game's story also had to be rather planned out and working. What's interesting about the game's original story is they never really discussed much about it. Aside from the premise of the game being Frank West as a photojournalist and a zombie outbreak occurring, they never actually revealed the game's main plot. Now, it would be easy to speculate that the game simply did not have a story at this point in development. However, after my years of working with this game, I've ever since collected an amazing amount of info on what the game's story might have actually been. Now, in the earliest months of Dead Rising, it was first initially showcased as merely a tech demo for E3. For quite some time, we all speculated that the E3 build was not playable, and that it was just a trailer of the game. However, after reading through many IGN articles, they have stated that in the final days of E3, Capcom actually presented a playable version of what was shown in the trailer. Now, it's my understanding that this playable version was not open to the general public, but large reviewers such as IGN and GameSpy had a chance to play the 10 minutes that the demo provided. They were not allowed to capture footage or images, sadly, so we can't exactly see how their demo played out. But the trailer gives us a good enough idea of what these reviewers actually got to play. It was stated that this build was so early that it completely lacked the in-game HUD. However, the game did function how it was supposed to. Although not much of the game's story was revealed at E3, in the later months, Capcom unveiled a new, more polished build at the Tokyo Game Show convention, which showcased immense changes including Frank, the zombies, and the actual mall itself. The mall at this point in development wasn't actually completely nailed out yet, so the layout was rather different. However, enough of the mall was actually implemented to have some kind of working story or plot revolve around it. In one IGN article, it stated that there was some kind of plot in TGS, saying that you would have to go to the butcher shop and rescue Isabella after fighting Larry. For the longest time, we always thought TGS played as a simple zombie survival demo with four savable characters, but as it turns out, the game actually made you go do one of presumably many case missions in the game. Now, of course, what's interesting about this is how the case actually plays out, where in the final game, we know you rescue Isabella after fighting Steven in Sean's Food and Stuff. However, in the TGS demo, you would find her held capture in the butcher shop. Now, this all sounds a bit fishy, seeing as there's no video proof, so I too didn't tend to really believe this as concrete evidence, or at least that was until I started doing some digging. In pre-E3's files, it actually contains a shitload of leftover TGS content, and some of the most amazing of which are loading screens and various splash screens in the game. What I'm about to show you has never publicly been seen since TGS 2005. This is presumably one of the loading screens that was used at TGS, which as you can see is unlike anything we got in the final game. To the left here we can see a little note over Isabella's head stating, "This woman knows something about the zombies, interrogate the woman concerning zombies," which was actually an in-game hint that scrolled across the bottom of your screen. And to Isabella's right, we can see the butcher shop with all the meat hanging down from the ceiling. Now this in its own right was amazing info, however it's not all. Here is another image found in pre-E3's files called clear_English, and there is also an exact duplicate of this called clear_Japan. As you can see, it showcases a very early Isabella model inside the butcher shop, which seems to be playing an animation very similar to the one she uses after saving her from Steven. So at this point, I was hooked. It's kind of amazing to think that originally in Dead Rising, you wouldn't confront Carlito in the butcher shop, which of course makes you wonder, where has Carlito been in this stage of development? Carlito's character was never actually hinted in any state of the game in trailers or much concept art, so it led many to assume his character was something that was added very late into development. And although his role might have been added in later on, Carlito's model has been around since the dawn of the game. As you can see, I actually have one of Carlito's possibly earliest models, which I found in the files of Pre-E3. Which this model actually matches up with his earliest artwork, so that's pretty cool. So it's interesting to imagine where Frank would encounter Carlito in 2005, and the simple fact is, we really have no idea. Also, in the development stage of TGS 2005, we got a short look at Jesse as a character, which in TGS, it's portrayed that she's in the maintenance tunnels, presumably being chased by something, but just from the light source approaching her, I would imagine it's Carlito in his truck. It also hints that Jesse would get killed and lean up against the wall instead of Brad, which would show a total shift in character development, as Brad should be the one down here fighting Carlito, not Jesse. Sadly, I don't have any early models of Brad, but what we do have is a bit of concept art for him, so Brad's character was for sure implemented somewhere in the game's story at this point, but Capcom wasn't ready to unveil his character to the public. Isabella was not only hinted in the butcher shop, however. In the TGS trailer, we see her armed with Carlito's Barrett 50 cal and clearing out some entrance plaza zombies. It's not exactly known where this would fit in with the game's storyline, or whether it was just for the trailer, but it is certainly interesting to see her in this setting. So there you have it. Dead Rising was a game that had its overall appearance change many times, and it seems its story also followed these changes. When a game is this early in development, it's rare the story is anything more than just work in progress. But Dead Rising was more than that. Its original story seems like it would have followed a much darker and grittier storyline, and hopefully someday we'll be able to play it. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it useful, and as always, subscribe for more.